Welcome back to another episode of the Teen Talks Podcast. We are here, not once again, because the first time we tried to do it, I couldn't post it.
It was rated R.
Rated R. There's no way that could have went out. I was looking back at it. When you watched it, what were you thinking?
Okay, to be honest, I don't know. Like, I didn't really care if he posted it or not. Like, I didn't really care if he posted it, to be honest.
I was just thinking about if my parents were watching that on a late night without me watching them. I wouldn't want that on YouTube, man. So we're back at it again, but this time we're gonna say it without saying it.
Real detail last time.
Like, you know what I might do though? I might post deleted scenes. I might post our podcast on my TikTok. So if you want to see that podcast of clips of it, at least I'll post it on TikTok. So go and follow that.
Yeah, because you can't post the whole thing. I didn't really care if you posted it or not, to be honest.
It was a me thing. If you guys aren't subscribed yet, go ahead and subscribe. The video. Today, me and Mauricio, we're gonna focus on a lot of things. We're gonna focus majority on like girls and relationships and just like fuckery and how we were before and how we are now, and it's just in general just like fun shit, but like, keeping it PG. So
yeah, we're gonna keep it PG this time, because last time it was rated R. It was not for YouTube community standards.
Literally, I think I would have gotten flagged if I posted that. You had that charismatic attitude
with
you were
girls,
always
with
good
the
with
girls.
The girls,
yeah, of course.
So I want to know, because for me back in the day I was a pussy, man.
To be honest, when I was younger, I was too. Like, I wasn't always like that. I guess it was just, I don't know, it came to a point where I just didn't give a fuck about like the way people saw me. I guess that's what it came to.
Yeah, it's hard though. It's really hard, because people could always say that, but at the end of the day, you always think about it late at night when
you're just like, damn. Like, of course, like when I was younger, more grade 6 and grade 7, I was just more scared. Like, do you know what I mean? I was just like scared. So then after, when I became older, like grade like 8, and beyond, I just, like, in grade 8, it was a real turning point for me. Like, I just completely, like...
Yeah, that's why when I, like, I see, like, my back neighbors, or, like, I remember seeing them so little, and they're, like, grade 8 now. I'm like, oh, my God.
Like, they're fucking huge.
Like, that's when it all starts. It's just, like, that's when, like... I always say this, especially in the Amanda's podcast. I was, like, the growing up in 21st century one. It was, like, yo, grade 6, when you enter grade 6 and you start getting your cell phone, it's, like, a whole new world, bro.
When did I get my first phone was in grade 6, too.
When you get your phone, it's, like, a whole new world. When I was younger, especially in grade 6, I was, not a loser, but, like, if I didn't have a twin, I wouldn't really fuck with a lot of people.
I guess,
you know, like my social aspect was like, I was social, but when it came to like girls and like the nervous times, like hanging out like Hannah's Wonderland and stuff, I was not there. Like it was so bad. Like I was always getting friend zoned. I could not, you know, the word of the day, initiate. I couldn't get to that girl. I couldn't get to that next level. So I was always sticking in friend zone no matter what girl I met. Cause I know you were fucking around way before me. I had my first kiss in grade 10. This guy fucked in grade 8. So
yeah.
What do you think progressed that?
I did not have, I had zero confidence grade 7. And then grade 8, it just like, I don't know. I just made a different type of friends. Like friends that were like
older than you, didn't you say?
No, yeah, like older than me. When I started chilling with people that were older than me in like grade 9. And then I just realized it wasn't the point, because I just realized I was doing stupid shit. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So going back to what I was saying, like I was just chilling with a different group of people. Like guys that were like more exposed to girls.
How did you make that friend group?
To be honest, they just came up to me.
Yeah,
like,
class.
I sat beside him in class.
Uh-huh.
His name was Gammy. He's probably
Gammy? Like, yeah. The guy that emceed my party?
That guy.
No way.
Yeah.
That guy. I was actually gonna have him on a podcast sometime.
Yeah, that guy. He films his own podcast.
Yeah, that's why.
And then me and him just started like going out, and then through him, I met Helder.
Because
Helder was also in my class. And then after from that group, I like started getting to know
more
like,
exposed.
Yeah, I was more exposed. My dad always had like a saying, like, who you chill with is who you are. Like,
yeah.
If you chill with people who are gonna like do drugs, you're most likely gonna do drugs.
Yeah,
you know what
facts,
I mean? Like
facts,
if you chill
facts.
With people that are like gonna rob people, like, you're gonna eventually gonna get exposed to where you're gonna rob someone.
Yeah,
know what I mean?
Facts, facts.
So I was with the group that like, they used to get like they used to just chill with girls all the time.
Uh-huh.
So then I just gained with them, I gained the confidence of being
I
like
see.
Of being more comfortable with myself.
Yeah.
So then like mid grade 8 is when I started talking to this girl, and then after I told her, oh, yo, give me a kiss and this, and I was like trying to like hit her up on Snap and stuff like that. That's how it came to be.
When I grew up throughout grade six, I was always in like Andrew's shadow. Like if I were to think like without Andrew how my social life would be, it would be like pretty rough.
I feel like you and Andrew just have different personalities. Like you're just more of a secluded person. He's just now, but I think before, like when I first met you, you're different than the way you are now. Do you understand?
Yeah.
Like when I first met you, you were more like conserved. And now I just view you more. Do you know what I mean?
Because I was always, I think there's just an attitude aspect towards it. I always had that inner confidence in it.
Yeah, of course.
Like, I always had that in me. Yeah. I was too rebellious to social norms. I didn't want to fit in, and that's why I stood out too much. And I think Andrew kind of balanced it for me. I wouldn't have any motives because I didn't have the confidence to like DM or like talk to someone or like create conversation with another person. And when I did create conversation with another person, it would always be too friendly. I didn't understand the difference between being friends and being a flirt.
Yeah, like a
so I would always come across as like a friend, a friendly guy. Like, oh, you're so nice. And like, no one would be like, you're kind of cute, because I never came off as like a fuckboy type.
Yeah.
And I prided myself for that. But then low-key, when I was thinking about it, I was like, damn, bro, like, I kind of want to be with like where Andrew is. I want to be having like bitches like text me and stuff. I want to have people lined up. I want to have a lot of friend groups and stuff. So I was striving for that. And I never really found the balance between it, and I still haven't until I think right about now, where it's like, I have that balance.
Now, Michael's chilling with the girl, bro.
Like now it's more so of like, I think it's just, I'm comfortable with myself. Rather than before.
But it's also the friend group you're around with now. Do you understand? Like, back to what I was saying. Like now you chill with like more exposed to girls.
Remember that first time when we met in science class and we got close and we're like, we're going to bring these girls over.
I remember.
Remember that night? That was pretty fun. That was fun. That was when I thought, I'm like, yo, I'm going to start chilling with this guy more just so I could get some. Because before then.
I remember everyone used to ask me to chill and they always be like, yo, go get girls.
Go get girls, bro. Because you were the guy. You were the guy.
Because
that's what Andrew said. He was like, yo, you should with Mauricio more because he could get you girls, because I was always relying on him. And at that time he had girlfriends, so it's like he's not gonna hold around anymore. With Chris, before Chris was a different animal.
Chris used to be like some silent motherfucker, bro.
Imagine trying to link with girls. Imagine trying to link with girls with Chris. It's like I always had to be that friendly
guy. That guy was in a show, bro. I literally took that guy in the show.
So that's, I want to talk about that now. It's like, when it comes to like Chris, or like, because I think we related it back to like hanging out with a different friend group. Like when I hung out with Chris, it was always, we were always down. We always had the motives. We were attractive dudes too. I mean, I would say we all grew up from grade 9, but even back then, I think I was not bad.
Yeah,
my hair could have used a little work, but once I got my braces off, I think I think I was good, Gucci from there. But I was super, super insecure, and I think that's why I came off so friendly. Because I couldn't have that aspect of like, damn, I could never initiate. I would always be so friendly, and like, I would, the nice guy.
Of course.
And I would never come across.
I realized that when I first started chilling with you right away.
Yeah, I was always the nice guy.
I realized that right away.
I could never I would always lure them in, but I never attack.
I guess that was like the difference between you and Andrew. I feel like you could have also got girls too, but I just feel like Andrew would have no, like,
he had
confidence.
He had that persona too.
Just to go at it, you know what I mean?
He had that fuckboy persona, and I think that's a little easier.
It is.
That's the things you have to little, like, sacrifice a little bit, and I wasn't willing to sacrifice it.
But you see, that's what I was talking about when I stopped giving a fuck. Like before, when I was younger, well, they still do, but like, everyone used to call me a fuckboy, like all the time. They used to be like, oh, you talk to their girls, especially the girls. But you know what? I started noticing that if you treat a girl right, they look past everything. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, that's facts.
Just ignore it. Do you know what I mean? They don't pay attention to it.
I think because when I was younger, I just couldn't get across to a girl in a flirty way, and I didn't know how to. My game then versus now is like my timeline of my game. What do you think the need is for a girl when it comes to like game?
I don't know. I just feel like you have to be confident. Try to turn into a friendship where you guys aren't friends.
I think it's key to like balance that friendship out with like low-key sexual references.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
What are we getting married? Like little kids like those. Like that. I think that's what kind of separates
it. You have to make yourself seem fun and reliable.
Fun, you know?
And reliable. Like, and you have to have confidence. Like, you have to, like, it doesn't matter. Like, I've been in mostly when I was younger, like, I would be put in situations where, like, I would say the wrong thing.
Uh-huh.
Or, like, I would say, like, for example, I remember I had one girl. I was like, why did God make you so... like beautiful, and she's like, I don't believe in God. Like, do you know what I mean? And, yeah. Like, you don't even know what to say after that.
That's a rough one, bro.
Yo, and I remember, I don't even
how do you even backfire from that, yo? Counterattack that?
I remember I counterattacked the shit out of that. But, like, I've had, like, such weird situations where, like, I just say the wrong thing. Do you know what I mean? But I feel like confidence is what keeps you there. Like, staying there. Do you know what I mean?
What is your advice for, like, youngins that are listening to this that, like, are having a little trouble with, like, girls? I'm not saying, like, a master class. It's just through experience and stuff, because I'm, like, talking to my cousin about it right now, and it's fucking hilarious because he's telling me about, like, all, like, these things about, like, his relationship. I'm like, bro, you're in grade 9, man. Enjoy it, bro. I was like, I'm, like, getting goosebumps just talking about this.
I feel like if you're younger, I don't believe you should be in a relationship. I feel like you should enjoy your high school.
Yeah.
I think it's that.
I think, too.
Because, like, throughout high school, I was never in a relationship, like, ever. Like, okay, yeah, I was in relationships, but I don't know.
Yeah.
My relationships are different. Yeah, a little different. They're a little bit different compared to what you guys may think, like, a standard relationship is.
Your strategy, when you see a nice girl walking down the street, what do?
I just try to come off as funny. That's what most girls are attracted to, like, funny and funny.
Yeah, guys. Sometimes I see, like, a nice girl walking down. It's just like, you can't just say, hey. Like, in today's generations, you can't just go, hey, what's going on?
Like,
you have to compare it to something. Like, let's say that you see someone at Starbucks, right? Well, in order to counter, you have to pose a question. You have to give them a question to answer. You know what I'm saying?
Really loud, and I'd be like, oh, yo, how was your day? Like, talk to the cashier.
Yeah.
Right? And she's beside me, and I know she's beside me. So I'd be like, what do you think? I'd ask the cashier first, what do you think I should get? And the cashier would look and be like, I don't know what you want. And then I would look at her, what do you think I should do?
Exactly. You know what I mean? There it is, bro. It's just, there's ways to connect in every situation. And once you find those ways to connect, it'll be easy to encounter them.
You have to play it off as something so basic.
Yeah.
You can't make it feel like you're hitting on
like
her.
Exactly. Because then it feels like that. Predatorial.
She feels like, he's hitting on me. Like, I'm going to ignore strong. Him. Or like, uh-huh. You know what I mean? So you start with something subtle. Like, you try to, like.
There it is. Yeah,
you
see?
Try to wedge yourself in there.
Starting a conversation is key. Like, if you're good. That's what I was saying. Like, I would always pride myself of keeping a good conversation. But the thing is, before, the conversations would be too friendly. Now, I would be able to show my interest without having to expose. We're coming off too hard.
Yeah, you have to show you're interested by not showing you're interested. Yeah. If you show a girl that you care, they don't like that.
Yeah. I don't know. It's so weird. It's so backward.
It's literally a game. It's a game.
Yeah.
100%. You have to play. The more you play chess, the better you get at it.
Facts.
You know what I
mean? Facts.
Like, you can't be too clingy to girls because girls don't like clinginess. But you can't be too distant.
Yeah.
Because they won't talk to you.
That's the fun part, bro. Have you ever had a girl, it's so easy to the point where it's just like, what the fuck?
Oh, bro. Yo, okay, yo. If, I don't know, to any girl that throws herself onto a guy, the guy's not going to pay attention to you.
Yeah, that's girls what's fucked
like,
up.
Guys like the chase.
Yeah, that's what's fun about it. The tease, the back and forth talk, the not too easy, the hard to get. That's what's fun, bro. When you have a girl come onto you really quickly, you're like, you're so over it, it's not even funny. Like, you're like, yo, I don't even find her attractive.
I know.
Yo, a girl could be like a straight 6, but if she plays games well,
you're attracted to the point like you want to achieve something. But if they're not that pretty, you're just gonna achieve it, and then once you get everything you want, you're just gonna be like, fuck, what's the point now? You know,
okay,
what I mean?
But nah, a girl has to be pretty in order for you to like at least try.
Do you know what I mean? Like, but she has to be pretty enough for you to try. But I feel
attitude's number one, bro. For me,
any guy or girl that says they're only interested because of a personality, they're lying. You have to be attracted.
Come
to
on,
them 100%.
Bro. That's the first thing you look at.
Bro, attraction.
Like, I mean, don't get me wrong. There's like a lot more. Like, sometimes I had girls where I'm like, okay, they're not as attractive as I thought they were, but to be honest, their attitude is what's
amazing. Yeah,
like,
no,
what's
I've
really attractive. And it's like, I'll see right through it.
Yo, 100%.
Because you enjoy it more. I don't know what it is, bro.
No, 100%.
When I have to chase, it's like,
it's so much more fun. It's different, yeah. Don't make them chase you to the point where they give up.
Yeah.
You have to give them like
little nudges.
You have to give some and take some.
Exactly.
You know I mean?
This one girl, yo, she doesn't send me emojis. She sends me the brackets, smiley face brackets, bro.
I fuck with those two.
Bro, I don't know what it is, yo.
Those things slap.
The fact that she has a portfolio of emojis that she could choose from and she decides to use fucking text. Oh my God, I love it. I don't know what it is.
I don't know, I fuck with those two, no cap.
The thing with game two is it's different everywhere you go, and the more versatile you are, the more fun it is.
I'm not the type of guy to text a girl, for example.
Yeah.
I don't text.
You don't text, eh?
No. I don't DM girls. I don't text them.
I hate snapping too.
If I'm gonna do something over, I'll call them.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? Like, I'll call them.
Some people don't like calling though.
I think it's intimate. You just have to make them feel comfortable over the phone, right?
Yeah.
It's just making them call you or like accepting your call. That's one thing. But like,
yeah, that's a good one.
Because over text you can't express yourself properly. Do you know what I mean? As much as emojis, like as many as emojis or or stuff you use.
Emojis.
Emojis, as much as yo, that's a tongue twister.
Emojis.
You can use as many as you want, but it can still come off differently. Like if I tell you, hey, how are you, it can, like, do you know what I mean? Depending on the context of like, you can interpret it differently depending on how you're feeling. Like if you're getting yelled at by your parents and I say something that can go two ways, you can take it wrong differently. And compared to if you were in a happy mood.
Have you ever seen that Kill and Peele skit where it's like they're texting each other back and forth and they're like, what? Like, how are you? Oh, how are you, this motherfucker? I'm all right. How are you? Do you want to go?
Yeah.
Go? Okay, yeah. So, like, that's what I'm thinking about right now.
Do you know what I mean? Like, it's because with tone of voice, people, like, you can express yourself better with tone of voice.
Uh-huh.
So, I feel like, I don't know, I'm more of an in-person type of guy. Like,
facts, yo.
If I'm
snapping a girl, right? In general, if I'm snapping a girl, I hate the back and forth conversations. It's like, yo, the only reason I'm snapping is just to keep a connection, right? But like, if we're not chilling in the next, like, you know, 2 to 3 weeks, yo, and I'm just snapping you back and forth, like, where's this going?
I hate doing that shit. Like, I don't just, like, I see on girls' phones all the time where they're on their phone and they're just snapping pictures of like ceilings.
Yeah,
and, like,
bro,
walls
what the
shit.
Fuck?
Like, there's no point.
I honestly hate that so much.
People do it just to stay in contact with the person.
Which is fair, but set up a convo.
Bro, I don't know. Not even, like, texting is just not my thing.
Yeah.
Like, I'm good at, like, if I really wanted to, like, I could text someone. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, I could hold a conversation.
Yeah.
It's just so time consuming.
Yeah.
And, like, people can just interpret it so differently that I just prefer calling them or, like, I prefer, like, meeting them in person.
What's your opinion on, like, text messages and waiting for snaps and stuff? Like, not answering right away?
Oh, yeah, that's another game. Like, you have to open the snap not too fast because you're going to look desperate or you can't take it too late because you show like you have no interest.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
It's so
but
bad.
But you also have those ones, like, with the girls, like, you snap, like, one day, you don't answer them for 24 hours and they won't answer you for 24 hours.
Yeah.
But on purpose.
Yeah.
Like, they know you snap them. They see your snap. They answer everyone but you.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
I don't... That's what I also hate about snap because the conversations are so elongated. I could text you something that I mean right that minute and then if you don't answer for 2 hours, that doesn't make sense.
Yeah, I know.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, I don't do snaps. I always FaceTime. FaceTime, no matter what.
I fuck with FaceTime, too.
Like, FaceTime's... Especially now, FaceTime's fire because it's the only way of communication you could get. Chrissy was saying, like, yo, these are, like, the prime time of our years. And the fact that we are, like, literally trapped. We're illegal now. We can go to clubs. We can have people at our house. We don't need to worry. We could buy our own alcohol. We don't have to worry about fake IDs and all that shit.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
There's so much freedom in that aspect. And then everything's just robbed from us. And we can't have people over.
I don't really feel the effects that much. I think it's just because I've been partying since I was, like, so young.
Yeah.
I started, like, going to clubs at 14. Like, when I was going to clubs with my dad and stuff like that. Like,
yeah.
I feel like if you're a parent, you should teach your kids how to drink.
Yeah.
Because, like, I see girls drink to the point where they can't control themselves.
Yeah.
Like, they're breaking shit. Like, I can't deal with that.
Yeah. On the floor.
I like classy girls, you know what I mean? The girls can get drunk. Like, they can drink. They can get drunk. But, yo, if you're going to get drunk, know how to act.
Yeah.
Like, don't start breaking shit. Don't start throwing yourself on the floor. Like, I
falling onto people. At some point, though, it's not so much pretending. It's the fact that, like, your body is just has so much alcohol in it. Like, I've been to a point where I've been so drunk out of my mind. I just fell asleep and, like, got up
and threw up.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, that happens to me, too.
So,
be honest, have you ever seen me drunk?
I seen you drunk, but not to the point where you're just falling on the floor. Like, I think out of all the guys in our friend group, you have the highest tolerance. And you could drink
a lot.
But, like, by the end of the night, you'll be so sober to the point where you could fucking walk a line for a kilometer.
Yeah, I know.
Like, it literally surprises me, the amount of alcohol you could consume.
I can drink fucking a lot, but I know how to regulate myself.
Yeah,
like,
I'm learning that right now.
Yeah, but, like, that's also another thing. You're learning it yourself.
Yeah.
Like, my dad was always the one to teach me.
Yeah.
Like, since I was young, because he knew, he was like, I'd rather you get drunk at home and you fall on the floor, me watching you fall on the floor, like, me supervising you so I can take care of you. And me teaching you the right way. When I go to other countries, like in South America, you have to act a certain way in a club.
Uh-huh.
Do you know what I mean? And if you start falling on the floor, people will use that against you. Like, when you go on a taxi, for example, they'll, like, rob you for all your stuff. They'll, like, go around in circles until you fall asleep and they'll rob you. Like,
uh-huh.
it's just a, I feel like it's just a different way of being raised. You know what I mean?
Yeah. If someone drank alcohol in grade 8, I thought they were druggy. Like, I was very innocent. I got drunk my first time in grade 10. First kiss, grade 10. Like, everything happened in grade 10. It was later. It was into high school. Yeah. And even when the first time I got drunk, I remember it was at this, like, it was a perfect time to get drunk. Mm-hmm. I was surrounded by all my friends. It wasn't a party, but it was like, I think there was like about 15 to 20 people there. Everyone was drinking. Like, my first time getting drunk was like a perfect drunk. My cousin, one time when I had him over at the pool, I'm like, yo, I wanna get you tipsy. I want you, like, yeah, exactly. I want you to experience it with me.
Rather than you
experience it with your friends.
Yeah, because when you experience with your friends won't stop you. Do you know what I mean? Like, well, I guess it depends. When you're older,
but your peer pressure is huge.
But yeah, do you know what I mean? When you're older, I guess your friends just watch you more because they just know.
Yeah.
Like, for example, like, I would make sure, like, you wouldn't drink that much.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
Because especially girls, too. Like, I regulate that shit, too. Last thing I need is someone fucking puking on the floor, bro.
Yeah, I know. It's such, like, a girl's kill. But
bad experiences.
Yeah, I don't want people to think like I was exposed to like, crazy amounts of alcohol when I was younger. No, like I started like obviously like drinking like a cooler, like one cooler.
Yeah.
Like when I was 14, and then by the time I was 15, I was like.
I think everyone took a sip of beer when they were 14 too.
Yeah,
right?
Like, you know what I mean? Like I was slowly building up, but my dad always wanted me to like learn to be
responsible.
Learn to be responsible, like drinking responsibly.
Yeah.
Like, I don't know, COVID doesn't affect me. Like, I don't have a desire to go to the club because I've been to so many fucking clubs. You know what I mean?
It's just that's what I'm saying. Like, it's like temporary happiness, but it's like, I think it's the whole social aspect because for me, especially, my house was always like, hey, come to my house, we'll do it. Like, I always had it. Like, without like my house, it's like, oh my God, we don't have any plans.
Yeah, of course.
You know? So I was like, and I loved hosting. Like, I love hosting in general,
too,
like
I
parties and stuff
too.
Like that. Because it's fun creating an atmosphere and stuff, you know? But like, I have like the pool and the basement and the licks and like all, it's like fun for me. Mm-hmm. And plus, I got the bedroom just in case.
Yeah.
But well, that's left to the Rated R podcast. But I have all these aspects to like, that's why. And plus, I don't gotta drive anywhere. I don't have to risk anything,
literally,
right?
Literally, it's the best throwing it at your
so
place.
With that aspect not there, having like hesitation to like ask my parents, hey, can I have these people over? Okay, not that many. Now it's like absolutely no one. It's just so hard because it's like, damn, we could have had motives for like the week lined up, and
yeah,
it just
and
you can't,
just can't.
You know,
yeah,
that's what I think I'm missing about it the most. It's the fact that like I can't. It's not even like the motives itself. It's like now it's other parents not letting the girls come.
And
it's like,
the girls go, yeah.
You know, and I think that the temporary, when we had like a little get togethers during COVID and stuff, mm-hmm. like when it was like regulated a little bit more and they softened it, cases were low. We had some get togethers and that was fun.
Yeah, but
we
like,
did it 2 weeks in a row. Guess what we did? Oh, this is kind of shit. It's fucking boring, you know?
I know.
Like we're like, yeah, we got a break. So I get that. I'm not too worried about that, but it's, I don't know. Now it's kind of like I miss it. I guess it's been a while.
But like, what's your opinion on, for example, like if someone's in a relationship and they want to go party, what would be your opinion on that? Like, what do you think?
Well, okay. So as you all know, I mean, if you don't already, Sneeko is one of my role models. I really fuck with him.
Yeah.
And I have his Patreon and he does these podcasts with Cass, which is his best friend, which is the reason why I wanted to talk about this on this podcast.
Yeah, yeah.
He said this one thing about cheating. When you cheat on a girlfriend, you understand how important the actual girlfriend is. And I never had a relationship, so I wouldn't know.
Yeah.
But the fact that, like,
on a bunch of girls.
Yeah. but not recently.
I'm just talking about before.
When you see what you have compared to, like, this trash you just fucked, like, there's a difference. He's saying this. He goes, there's fucking a girl and making love. When you're fucking someone, it's just a quick clearing the tubes. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But when you're, like, making love, it's just, it becomes a little bit more intimate.
It is.
And I had a phase where, yo, I'm over this. You know?
Yeah.
I'm over just going around. Like, I want someone to, like, hold tight. You know what I'm saying?
But you say that until you have it.
And then you
want the other thing.
Yeah,
it's just like,
I
noticed that.
People want what they can't have. People
in general want what they cannot have. Like, for example, millionaires or billionaires, they have all the money in the world, yet they want to be broke.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? Like,
think being broke was better. That's a J. Cole line.
Someone who lives in a big house, they want a bigger house.
Yeah.
But you already live in a big house.
Nice car. You want another nice car.
You want another nice car. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah. Well, I think I say this again and again and again. It's one of my mottos that I always say. It's like once you have so much of something, it loses value, right? So like you can never have too much this, too much that. The chase. Exactly.
The chase.
Coming
chase.
Back with like the girls. It's like it's just the chase.
It's
that's
the
fun part, right?
Yeah.
Yo, I do want to get back on that topic about like chasing, because I think we covered a little bit of it, but I want to get back on like, what is the most attractive thing a girl can do in that situation?
Let's
put a scenario. Party.
Okay,
scene.
So when I'm at a party, I I like when girls play games.
Yeah.
Eye contact, like, you know, like they're on you, but they're not.
I was gonna say, like they tease you, the gas pedal comes on, they tease you a bit, and then they just come off. And it's just like, I think I developed this philosophy, okay? Yeah. You wanna hear it?
Go.
Force versus fun, okay? Yeah. When you're with anyone in a party, it also comes to the balance of trying too hard, but not trying enough, the balance of it. You wanna force it to the point where she sees a direction you're going, but right when she's into it, you pull back and you go, let's dance, let's do that, let's take a shot, let's do something else. Yeah. So it doesn't seem too needy. And then once she like inches over that force part, you know, you kind of like, you bring her closer and then she puts your arms on you or whatever. Yeah. Then you push it a little bit more. And when she's in, you pull back to fun. Because if you don't do force over fun, you're going to force it too much. Like, yo, come upstairs. No, it's okay. Okay, backfire. You know what? Fuck it. Don't ask her anything for the next 20 minutes about anything sort of sexual because you're going to force it too much, you know?
Yeah. Of course. Like,
what do you think about that?
I agree with that, but like, I don't know. I'm just the type of guy to like, I try to party myself. I try to have fun, and that usually attracts people.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? Like, I try to be the most fun one there. Like, I try to be fun.
Like the leader, kind of.
Like, do you know what
you
I mean?
You take like, that role pretty good.
Yeah,
I try to make
everyone have fun.
Yeah.
And that usually, I usually like attract like a girl like that. But like, I try to go around, be fun.
Yeah.
Be friends with even when I'm at a club, like try to become friendly with like the booth that I'm in and the booth beside me.
Uh huh. Remember that time we got beers from those guys because you were friendly?
Yeah.
Remember that time? Like, we got fucking 4 beers from these fucking guys. Because Mauricio was like, yo, but I don't know, because you make friends so easily.
It's because I'm a social person. Like, I try to, like, I know what boundaries to cross and what boundaries not to. If you become too friendly with the group's going to try to hit on the girls in your group. And then all your boys are going to get salty about how they're taking the girls you brought. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So
it's just like create like a like an agreement, like a handshake rather than like a hug.
Yeah. Do you know what I mean? Like, you have to be friendly to the point, but like, you friendly, but they're not in your group.
Yeah.
They're in their group and we're in our group.
I guess just
we're just friendly with each other. You know what I mean? Like, if you want a shot, you'll come take a shot. Uh-huh. But then as soon as I'm done giving you the shot, go back to your fucking group because don't stay here. Do you know what I mean?
Like, I think, well, clubs, that's what I'm saying most of the time with game. It all depends on atmosphere, right? You could have really good game in a club, but when you're one-on-one, you have no idea. Because it's so much different, bro. Like, when I'm one-on-one, it's like, you really gotta work it. You really gotta work it. Because especially when there's no drinks. Because drinks, don't get me wrong,
that's where my childhood really helped me.
It doesn't. Okay. Because there's a fine line between getting a girl drunk to fuck them and like getting a girl drunk to loosen them up. You know what I'm saying? Because when you're both loose off alcohol, you feel a little bit more comfortable.
You feel more confidence.
Exactly. It brings your confidence up.
I feel like if you get a girl drunk to the point where you're just trying to use them to fuck them, that's fucked up.
Yeah.
But like, I feel like
I always do one shot me, one shot you. I always take a shot with them. Yeah.
Like, I always do that too. Like, I always feel like, yo, if everyone's going to take shots, the whole group take shots or just... Like, don't start handing out shots to one girl just because you're trying to get...
That's fucked up. Do you know what I mean?
But also, you have to think about the fact that some people hold their liquor different. Yeah. So you have to also...
It's all a game, bro.
But like, it's...
We talked about cheating. Mm-hmm. I want to know your opinion on cheating in general. Do you think cheating strengthens a relationship?
It can go two ways, no cap.
Yeah.
It can go two ways. It can go to the point where you want the other person instead of the person you're with, or you want to be with your girl more.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? It can go two ways. It can go, you fuck this girl and fuck, she was the most amazing girl you ever had in bed.
Uh-huh.
And then you don't want to be with the girl you're with anymore. Or it can be go to the point where you get with her.
And you're like, damn, it's not, this bitch is nothing. It's not worth it. It's not nothing compared to what I have.
Do you know what I mean? It can go two ways. It's just more, I don't know. I feel like being locked up with someone for so long causes a strain.
Yeah.
In a relationship. I feel like when you're in a relationship, you should have the right to go out. You should have the right to do what you like, go out with your friends. And if your friends bring girls, they bring girls. Like, what are you gonna do? You're not gonna not chill with your friends because they bring girls.
Yeah.
You have to be able to respect your relationship to the point
where
like,
trust, right?
Do you know what I mean? Like, where you don't like going out with your girl all the fucking time is amazing. Comes to a point where you just don't wanna bring her.
Yeah.
You wanna just be around other people. You know what I mean? Like, you just want to talk to someone else other than your girl.
If you cheat on a girl at least once a month, you'll understand what you have at home. you'll understand that aspect of it.
Yeah, but then also
another it's topic. So sticky, bro. I don't know what to think about it.
Another topic is, yo, would you want her to cheat on you?
That's what I'm saying. I won't.
Yeah, but you want to cheat on her. Like, it's,
see, that's what I'm saying. Like, I that's what I understand. That's why I always, when I'm thinking about it like that way, it's like, okay, well, you might get bored of this girl, and then when you fuck someone, you might understand it. Like, that's low-key true, but at the end of the day, you don't want that to happen to you, so why are you going to do it to her? And
it's sticky as fuck. Like, I don't know. I feel like guys are just able to. It's really hard for a guy to. If a girl throws, I don't know. When a guy's drunk and a girl throws themselves onto a guy is going to. I met loyal ass guys. Like, fuck. Like, you can bring her. You can bring the guy a fucking prostitute, get fully naked, and the guy won't do anything. I met guys like that.
Yeah.
But I've also met guys that
fuck like, around. With
you know what I mean?
Yeah.
That guy, like, they don't.
They're just different. They're just like, if you're comfortable in your relationship, I don't see why you would want to cheat. Understanding that your girl is above these other bitches that you're fucking.
Yeah, yeah. That,
is, that's it makes the relationship stronger in your eyes. But if she finds out, it's such a bad thing.
It's such a.
That's what's sticky about it.
It's such a. I don't know, bro. Like, I feel like. Bro, I don't even know how to explain it. Like.
I think. But then again, we're still young. Like, cheating on someone when you're like. You know, have your life put together
No. Yeah, that's fucked up. You shouldn't do that. Like, if you have your kids, I don't believe you should cheat.
Yeah, that's fucked.
That's fucked. Because
I'm not talking about that aspect. Yeah, that's you're way too far into it to get out or just typically have, like, some sort of... Yeah. Like maybe, like, to clear the tubes if the wife is not happening and you just order a prostitute and just go ahead. Maybe there's an exception. But even, like, it's the aspect of going back from before of like the difference between fucking and making love.
But also, what's cheating? Do you know what I mean? Some people call cheating differently. Like, some girls would consider cheating you even being around another girl. Like, some girls would also be considered cheating you fucking another girl.
The thing is, I'm very, like, I never had a girl, but like, if I know if I ever do, I'm like, I'm the type of guy to be like, not saying I will. But I know I am because I'm a very emotionally attached person.
Yeah,
you know? So when it comes to like girls, especially a relationship or a first one, mm-hmm. to be fair, yeah. I would be very not on top of it because I would still give freedom, but I would always have that in the back of my head, like, oh, my girl's with a bunch of these guys. Do I trust her? Do I this, like that, like question and stuff. Like, there's always like this gut feeling that I feel like that would happen.
Guys are very territorial.
Yeah.
They're very possessive.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Guys, they tend to be like that. I'm not like that. Like, me personally, I just feel like, yo, if I can do it, why can't they?
Yeah.
Like, I prefer if they don't.
Because where's the relationship, man? Where's the connection? If you're just, you rather get pleased by another girl. You rather get pleased by another guy, you know?
That's
like, you
true
can't,
too.
You're not satisfied with the one you have.
That's true.
But in the moment, it's very hard.
Yeah,
especially as a guy. Like, girls could go to the club and get a hookup or get taken home no matter what. You know, they're the choosers, you know? The guys are the ones that have to prove themselves.
100%.
You know, that's why they let more girls in the clubs than guys. So that's why they give the girls access to the for free, or like the bottle service. Like, girls get more shots. So they go, hey, how's it going? Flirting, get some guys alcohol and then run away.
Yeah.
Like, girls have that position where they can pick and choose. So when it comes to like a guy cheating, it's if a girl is throwing herself on you, it's in the back of your head, you're just like, damn, bro.
It's difficult.
It's difficult.
Very difficult. You get put in situations where you're just like, I don't know if I should do it or if I shouldn't.
And then you got peer pressure from your boys. Like not even like the verbal, but like you seeing like, damn, look at all my boys just fucking hooking up and doing their thing and me just sitting down because I got a girl, bro. There's a girl right there. And she won't know. She won't find out. Like, all these drunk thoughts are happening. You're just like, damn, you know what? Fuck it, you know?
I guess, I don't know.
That's why I like it. It's kind of controversial, but kind of debatable.
It is. It's, I don't know. It depends on the relationship, but what you guys consider cheating.
If we're going back in the ape ages, okay, men would spread their seed and girls would pick who to spread their seed. Girls would be like, I think this guy is suited for me. I'm going to marry him. I'm going to have kids with him, have a family. That's the reason why sex was created, reproduce, right? Is this man not only going to raise my children, but provide money, provide food, all of the above? Now it's coming to a point where men and women are equal. Like,
still,
you know?
It's still like, I don't know. I feel like when a girl sees a guy, this is another thing about attraction. Girls are attracted to guys that just are better. Like, for example, if you go up to a girl, like, I saw like a social experiment on YouTube. The same guy went to like a bunch of girls in a suit.
Uh-huh.
And went just wearing casual clothing,
uh-huh.
And they noticed the guy in the suit were able to get more girls than the guy. It's just mentally.
I think girls like when guys' lives are put together.
Yeah.
But then again, you have these girls that go for bums, right? And then it makes people want to be bums so they could get the attraction. That's the thing that I was going through in grade 9, where it was like, I'm a well put together dude. How come I can't find love?
I feel like, you know? Because girls like bad boys.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
Come on the show. Anyone that has a rebuttal to this, come on the show. I think that girls like guys put together now. You know, now is the time. Because you could get away with that shit when you're younger, no?
No, I feel like now that you're like everyone's out of high school, girls want guys that can take them out. Can provide. Like, do you know what I mean? Like, I'm a type of guy, like, I don't let a girl pay. It doesn't matter if they're not my girl or anything. If I'm with a group of girls, I don't let them pay.
Yeah.
I was brought up that way. Do you know what I mean? Like, I don't let them play for anything.
One time I had a friend pay. Like, I just didn't have a card. I didn't have my card. Yeah. Like, I didn't have cash on me. I literally didn't have money. I was like, oh my God. I was like, yo, can you get this one? That night, I ended up forgetting to pay her back, right? Mm. That night, I booked it. I couldn't sleep. Like, it was like, damn, bro. And I think that's like an ego thing. It's like, yo, like, she just bitched me. Like, she owns me because she paid for my food. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's one of those that you could come across as that. But it's a gentleman move. That's how like a social norm, right?
100%.
Like, if you're taking someone out, you're going to pay for them. If they're helping you out, you're going to pay for them. I just feel guilty, man.
Yeah, and it's just like, I just feel like a girl shouldn't have to pay when they go out with you. They just, not even when you're in a relationship, a girl doesn't have to pay for anything. Like, I just feel like,
it's like your treat kind of thing.
Do you know what I mean? You're gonna come if a girl goes out with me, they're not gonna pay for anything. We can go anywhere.
Yeah,
they won't pay for anything.
You know, like that meme where, like, on TikTok, where it's like, "Are we having sex tonight?" And they're like, and then he goes, "Pay, like, not split tab, but pay all." And he just stabs it. Like, I mean, don't get me wrong. That's where your intent is. It's like, okay, maybe if, like, I treat her good, she'll give me some.
I've been with girls who have boyfriends. Uh-huh. They happened to be in the group, and I still paid for food. It's just knowing that I wouldn't get anything. It's more being you have to be
superior too. It comes out of that.
You have to just be classy.
Yeah, that's what it is. It's just class.
I'm really big on class. Like, I don't like unclassy girls.
And I remember when I was fucking around, I was with this one. It was so dirty to me, like, in the sense of, like, how it happened. I wasn't working for anything. It was just flat on the table. It was bad. If it comes too easy, then you feel like you got cheated. Like, it's like getting really good on the test, but you know you cheated on the whole thing. It's kind of like, yeah, I did good, but I didn't really learn anything. I kind of just cheated the whole thing.
Yeah.
But when you work on it, when you study really hard and you achieve something and you work really hard, and then you finally get it, it's like more rewarding. When you do everything the whole, like, one night, you know, meet them, hook up, you know, do the rest, the rated R shit. Yeah. It is the worst, bro. Because once you do everything with them, there's nothing to look forward to.
I don't know. With me, I've had girls where I just hooked up with them for the first night, and I've hooked up with them like the first night, and it was fucking amazing.
Hook up the whole nine yards?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah?
Like the first time I met them.
And then
it was fucking amazing.
Every time I get to that, it's always one night stands. Like, it was always for the night.
I always, whenever I do that, I always, like, end up having a fuck buddy or some shit.
Yeah, no, not for me. Because most of them are just, like, it's for the night. And I don't care. Like, that's cool. Like, that's for the night, too. Like, one time I tried to, like, push it a little bit more. But when you do everything the whole night, there's nothing to look forward to. It makes it stronger, too. It makes your drive stronger to, like, actually snap and actually chill with them. Because you're always, like, you're, like, hooking up with them, whatever. And you're like, damn, what it would be like to do this. And you're just like, fuck, now I got to snap right now. I got to, you know. Now you're, like, you're a little bit more excited to, like, pick them up for the second time, because you're fuck, let's go
like I'm trying to get something done.
Do you ever know? You never hype yourself up before you pick up a girl. You're like, okay, let's get it going, come on now.
I don't even have the drive like that anymore, bro. Like, it's just
okay, well, not now, but like before, you were just like,
when I was younger, I had a very like big drive. Like, I wanted to like it's like a horny little bastard.
Like, it's like, now it's time. Like, now it's the time to, like,
now it's just like,
if I don't get this, I'm a bitch. Like, you really, and it goes back to the force and fun, right?
Yeah.
You know, it's just, bro, it's just fun now. It's just fun.
Yeah.
Just playing the games, bro. It's just fun.
It's, but like, I don't know, bro. Like, if I don't get anything, I'm okay. Do you know what I mean? I just rather have their company. I'm like that.
Oh, shut the fuck up.
I'm not playing, like, real shit. Like,
yeah, okay.
No, real shit. Like, I, like, even if I don't get anything from a girl, like, I'm okay with it. Like, do you know what I mean? I don't expect every girl that chose me to fuck me.
Or yeah, to get with me. Fair. I don't think it's right to do it the first time. For me, personally, when it comes to, like, getting them, like, whole nine yards and stuff, it has to happen like a sequence. Like I had it when I had it all at once many times. And it all sucked.
The majority of yours.
Majority of mine was all at once. Yeah. You know? But the times where it was kind of spread out.
You enjoyed those,
because you the build up, the lead up. It's like the like you're like up. you're thinking about them all the time because you're like, damn, I gotta finish them off. You know that not in that way, not in that way. But you know what I'm saying? Like
that too.
The first time you watch a show, you know the first episode's always sick because that's the hook you in, to lead you on, right? But it has to, it gives you a sense of what the whole season's about. If you first go full throttle and you binge watch the whole season, it gives you nothing to look forward to. So if you do the whole season in like 3 days, you're like, damn, now what do I do? And it's the same thing with the girl. It's like if you do a whole season in one day and you don't spread it out into different seasons, different episodes, it's gonna get boring, bro, and you're just gonna drop it.
I don't know, for me, it adds
to the experience, man.
I feel like, for me, I don't really care like if you have good fucking like good proper like hookup, like everything goes fucking well and you guys like both enjoy it. I feel like you'll fuck them again like the next day. Do you know what I mean? It's just
not after a party, bro. Not after
for
a party.
For me, it's happened many times.
I don't know. It's just how we came across it, bro. Maybe you're better or whatever. But for me, I just can't. I don't know what it is. It's like I rather have it spread out. It gives me more to think about. And plus, it gives you a motive.
And I understand where you're coming from, but it's just like, you could do all of that and you could get to know them after. Like, do you know what I mean?
No, bro. Like, some girls, when they get everything at once, they don't even want to deal with it anymore. They just think it's a one-night thing. But when you don't, like, because it's the tease goes both ways. Like, you're attracted to them even more because they tease you. Mm-hmm. If they give it to you all at once, it becomes less attractive. I don't know what it is. It's because you got to work a little harder. And, like, that goal is so much more achievable when you work a little harder at it. That's my opinion.
I understand. You know? I understand where you're coming from. Like, but, like, I don't know. For me, it's just so time-consuming. Do you know what I mean?
I guess so. It means more, though. When you spend it out, it means way more, bro. Yeah.
But, like, I don't know. For me, I don't know. I just like doing everything in one shot. But I also like spreading it out, too. Like, I do a mix of both.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? I do a mix of both.
You always had, like, well, obviously, like, grade 11, I would say. Yeah. Like, when we were first, like, really chilling, like, grade 11, you always had, like, things lined up. Like, it was like, hey, if it's not this one, it's gonna be the next one. Okay, this one can't chill, the next one.
So
it's like you don't have that to like worry about. Okay, if you push this girl too much and she's kind of offs it, you're like, fuck it, whatever.
I like having like
variety, because it's like, okay, once you don't like, let's say someone can't chill that night, okay, fuck it, let me get this other group, right? So I guess that's the fun part about being single, is to have that aspect
have
of
have that aspect of
not being held down
at all. Being in a relationship is very straining, but it also comes with its perks. Like, you know, you have a girl that you always can look to,
especially now during COVID, bro.
Even that, like,
you can't even meet people like in the club or online or something.
And
you know,
it's also like you always have someone to look at. Do you know what I mean? You always have someone there, and there's always gonna be like supportive and to talk to.
That's what I wanted. Like, it's actually, I think it's just winter blues when it comes to like December time, and you see everyone posting their pictures with their couples, and like they're going like the fucking, what's it called, that Christmas market and the light show. You're just like, damn, bro,
I wanna go there.
Which one am I gonna choose? You know, like,
but like being single is expensive.
Yeah.
Like, especially for me, because
you could also argue being single dating is expensive because you gotta fund two people. If you're with a friend or whatever, like you say, you pay for everything, everyone.
Yeah.
Like, if you're like really good friends with someone and they're like, you guys are going out for food and stuff, and they insist on paying, right? And they actually insist on paying, not like the fake, like, is he looking? Not like that. I think the only thing you could do is, you know what, you really want to pay for what you eat. I'll pay for what I eat. And that's where you could come into agreement. If it's a girl and you're taking her out, that's when you gotta, you know, like, there's a time and a place. If you're going to like lunch or whatever, you know what I'm saying? Like, a girl pays for her meal, you pay for yours if you're dating and
but
stuff.
But also,
you know?
My mentality is, if you're so close with one girl, then, and she's your friend, if you're gonna spend a bunch of money on girls that are not your friends, why won't you spend it on a girl that is your friend? Do you know what I mean? Girls that you're getting with. Okay, so like I'd rather pay for one of my best friends that are girls, like, even if they, like, regardless of where they went, because they hold a value, they talk to me, they care about me, and
you value them more than you value like some other random.
Do you know what
bitch,
I mean?
Yeah.
Like, it's just I value them more, so I'm gonna pay for them regardless. I've had girls who literally just come out with me because I pay for everything they indulge in.
That's fucked up though. Then it comes to like, oh, I'm just going to go with Mauricio because he's going to pay for my food. And then it becomes a habit. And that's what I don't like. I think that people should have their own. You work for your money, you pay for your money. I'm going to take you out, no problem. But I'm going to take you out fucking 30 times. Unless you're my girlfriend, I'm not going to fucking feed you. You know?
I get that too. But it's just like, I won't. Even though I know what they're doing,
This is like the cheating fucking conversation. Yeah, bro. Same thing.
Even though I know what they're doing, like I literally have a clear picture of a girl in my head right now. They're literally coming out with us because they know with us it's simple. Like you're gonna come have fun. You know, to come with us, it's a guarantee having fun, and it's a guarantee they're not gonna spend a dollar. They're just gonna come out and they're gonna have fun for free.
We read it well. I don't want to cover it so much because if you really, really want to know my fucking thing, I think I have a whole clip on it with Amanda, where it's probably like the first thing we talk about in that podcast. So go watch that. Mm-hmm. But yeah, money and friends are sticky, and I think that there should be a balance. Yeah, with girls it's a little different, like, but with friends, there should be a balance.
No, between your boys, yeah, 100% has to be a balance.
But I think that a good friendship consists of not even having to ask.
Yeah. No. We don't, our friendship, we don't really ask each other. Our friendship is more like we just fuck around with each other.
Yeah, I'm saying. It's like, especially with our friend group, it's like, I don't know if we're fucking, if you're joking around, playing around, or it's like you're actually going to pay for this, you know? But I think mutually we all have good morals when it comes to like sharing money.
Yeah, all of us are very fair with each other. No cap, we all help each other out.
I think it's time to wrap it up. I don't even know where we got from like fucking. We went all over the place, but I think.
We went everywhere.
I think overall this is a pretty cohesive podcast.
This is a pretty PG podcast.
Pretty PG, but very controversial.
Very controversial.
When it comes to like cheating or friends or payments, there's a lot of sticky situations. I think it opens up a lot when it comes to thinking about things. Hopefully we didn't say anything too harsh. I don't think we did, but
we're gonna look back
and be like, damn. Nah, I'll be fine. I think that these podcasts are fun when you look back at them and you're like, haha, like you can laugh at it. Yeah, right. Thank you guys for watching another episode of Teen Talks Podcast. Mauricio, thanks for coming on.
No problem, bro.
And I'll see you guys in the next one.
It don't matter. It don't matter.